This is what we're building today. It's a 96 watt LED grow light. It's cooled passively and anyone can make it if they just know how to use a screwdriver. So all of the parts for this 96 watt LED grow light cost me only $57. Now plants respond to certain frequencies of light. Traditionally commercial LED grow lights have used red and blue frequency lights. However, plants have adapted to grow under the sun, which is why I'm using daylight globes, and they also respond to some other frequencies of light such as green, so I've decided not to pretend to be God and I'm giving them natural daylight. And this is the parts list. First of all, we need one small scrap piece of wood, which should be free. Then we need 8 GU10 light sockets, and they will cost about $8.11 or so. Next we need 2 Choc boxes, which are about $3.22, and they need to come with a terminal block included. Then we need about 3 meters of basic 3-core electrical cable, and that will be about $1.50. Then we just need a standard power plug for about $1.29. And then we just need 4 of these hooks, which cost about $1.29 each. We need some string or twine, which is super cheap. And then we need some number 4 gauge screws, which can be cheap or free if you've already got some. And finally, we need 8 of these 12 watt LED downlights, which each have 4 3 watt LEDs, and they're passively cooled, so they're fantastic. The tools you need will just be a screwdriver and either scissors or a knife, and that's everything you need. The magic bullet with this LED grow light is the off-the-shelf parts that we use. Now the best grow lights have 3 watt diodes for excellent light penetration. These 12 watt LED down lights include 4 3 watt diodes each, and the best thing is, if one of them breaks, you can just go and buy another one and screw it straight in. And they're passively cooled as well, so there's no need for a fan. In the first step, we need to get 2 of the GU10 sockets and wire one of the wires from each socket together. So it's quite simple, just lay them out next to each other and twist the wires together, one from each socket. So in this case I've taken the bottom wire from the top socket and the bottom wire from the bottom socket, and I'm just twisting them together. And you do the same with the other pair of wires. It's quite easy to do, there's nothing difficult here at all, just make sure they're twisted together properly and that they'll hold. Next, we do the same with a second pair of GU10 sockets. It's quick and easy. And then we need to wire each pair of GU10 sockets into a terminal block. So one set of wires goes into the top hole and one set goes into the bottom hole. That's quite easy to do. Just stick them in and screw them down tight. We need to repeat that process, so we have 2 sets of the same of 4 sockets, and then we need to start wiring those together. To wire them together, we need a short length of electrical cable, and what we do is we take the red or brown wire and we wire that to the top terminal of the terminal block. Then we take the blue or black wire and we wire that into the bottom terminal of the terminal block, and then finally we wire the yellow wire, which is the ground, into the middle socket. And if that didn't make sense, I'm going to do exactly that now. So here's a short length of wire. I need to strip both ends, and then I need to strip the wires that are inside. So I'll take about an inch off of the outside shielding, and then I'll take probably about a quarter to an eighth of an inch off the inside. Take them all out, give them a good twist, and then wire them in with the GU10 sockets in the terminal block. Can be a bit fiddly. You might prefer to twist them together with the wires from the GU10 sockets, but it's not too difficult at all. All you need is a screwdriver and then you're done. And this is what the finished product looks like. So as you can see, the brown's at the top, yellow in the middle, and the blue at the bottom. Now what I'll do is I'll fit that into a Choc box to make sure that it's all secure. And then finally I'll stick a power cable on the end. So here's the one which has been wired with the power cable in the same way. As you'll see, there's a wire coming out each each side. One is going to the second choc box and one is going to the power cable. As you'll see, the top wire on both is brown, the bottom wire on both is blue, and the middle wire on both is yellow. Then we just need to shut the choc box and screw it down tight. And this is to make sure no one ever electrocutes themselves and makes it nice and safe. So this is what we've got. We've got one choc box with four GU10 sockets coming out. Then we've got a short length of cable, and then we've got another choc box with four more GU10 sockets coming out. And then at the end of all of that, we have our power plug. So I've given myself about 2.5 meters of power cord, and that should be plenty, but you can make it longer if you need. And then the next step is to screw it all down onto a wooden board. And this is all quite easy. Just get yourself a wooden board, line everything up. It might help to draw some marks. I did, but in the end, it can also just be as easy to eyeball it and then screw it down securely. Now, this is version 1 of the DIY LED grow light, and you'll see that in screwing the sockets down, there is a bit of pinch on the cables on the sockets. In version 2, which I've actually already started building, I actually screw through the wood and feed the cables through the wood. Now, I'm using a crude measuring device, a piece of paper, to measure where to place the next four sockets. So I'm taking a rough measurement, drawing myself a rough little guide, and then I'll screw those down. Again, same process, screw them down, make sure they're secure and nicely spaced. I'm also screwing down the choc box, the choc box, because I don't want any part to really move, and that's a nice secure part of the whole structure. And this whole process has taken probably about 20 minutes so far, so it's so quick, and there's nothing there that people can't do. And this is the assembly at the moment. So as you can see, there's 8 sockets screwed down onto a plank of wood, and there's no exposed wires or any of that. And so we'll fit the light bulbs in, easy, just push them in and screw them on, and then we'll turn them on and see if they work. Voila, they work. Now if they don't work, you don't have to worry too much, because there will be plenty of failure points and you'll just blow a fuse. And finally, we need to add some hanging points. So we'll flip it over, and with the hook screws that I had, or the hanging hooks, I had to drill little pilot holes because they wouldn't self-tack. But again, that's quite easy. If you really were desperate, you probably could self-tack them, but I didn't bother. So the process again from start to finish. Two GU sockets, twist a wire from each together, and then do that again for a second pair. That's super simple. Wire them into a terminal block. Again, that's extremely easy. All you need is a screwdriver, and then repeat the process. So you've got two of those. Wire them together with a piece of cable with the red or brown going to the top, blue or black going to the bottom terminal, and yellow going to the middle terminal of each. And then add a power plug, wire it in the same way. That's easy. Then screw it all down onto a wooden board, and finally, just add your hanging screws, which couldn't be easier. And here it is, completed and turned on. It's hanging from strings from the top of the grow tent, and the power intensity is really fantastic. It's very directional, it's very strong, there's not going to be any trouble growing with these lights. The hanging is fine, it works well. With four pieces of string, you can adjust it so it hangs in different angles. And the great thing about version 1 of this grow light is that it also acts as a bit of a shelf. So I put my maximum minimum temperature gauge on top, and I'm happy to say that these lights stay very cool and they don't need a fan at all. I've already started building version 2, so subscribe now. If you want to see the diagrams, they are on my Facebook page. Just look for Real Vince Samios on Facebook and look for the person, not the page. And as I said, subscribe, and we'll be growing some things with these grow lights shortly. Thanks for watching, and subscribe.